Hi, I'm Lindsay Jones, voice of Ruby on the animated show, Ruby. Autodesk Maya is an important tool in the creation of our show. It's the primary software used in many of our pipelines, including modeling, rigging, animating, lighting, rendering, and visual effects. Today, Rooster Teeth rigging artist Gio Cotinho will be showing us how she uses Maya for character rigging.
In this video, I'll be going over a method to skin multiple children of the same parent evenly and consistently. A very common occurrence of this is with fingers. You want to make sure that when all of your finger joints are selected, they all move at the exact same rate. All of these verts should be moving evenly and smoothly. The way I usually do that is I start off with one single finger chain and I key it. And then once that's done, I go into the mesh and select some verts in order to paint the skin. You'll notice that I'm selecting not only verts for the index finger, but also for all the others except for the thumb. And once I actually paint those influences on, you'll see why I do that. As usual, I will lock all of my influences except for the wrist and the first index joint, and I will take from the wrist and flood to that joint, taking from the parent and giving to the child. And once you scrub through the animation slider, you can see that all of the fingers are moving. And even though you don't want all of your fingers to move with the index joint, you can see that the skinning is consistent throughout all of these verts. Now, if you go back into vert mode, you can grow your selection, and you'll want to smooth that skinning out next. And in order for this method to work, you need to make sure that your selection is correct. If not, you can mess up the consistency between all of these verts and their influences. So we'll scrub through, go into smooth, and flood that out. Once you're comfortable with how that looks, you can go back into your first joint, delete those keys, and key the next knuckle. Once more, you'll want to make a selection, which will again include all of the fingers, not only the index. And once your selection is done, you can go into Paint Skin Weights tool. Your new parent joint is now the index one, so you'll want to lock the wrist joint and unlock the index two. You'll go into Replace and flood those weights over to the new child. And as usual, you'll want to smooth that skinning out. Repeat once more with the last joint on this chain. Now, if you look over here, you'll see that that's clearly not how you want your pinky skinning to look like. But this is something that we will take care of later when we transfer over the skinning from the index to the other fingers and to the other joints. So I actually made a wrong selection right here, so I will go back in, remove the influence from these verts, send them back over to the index 2 bind. And then once more, I will smooth these weights out. Now, the most important part of this whole process is the actual transfer over to the other fingers. So let's say we key all of these joints into a fist. Of course, all of the other fingers are following right now because they have index influence. But that will soon change when we go back into the mesh and select verts for all of the fingers except for the index. And this selection will do. We'll go back into the Paint Skin Weights tool. And if I go through the animation slider and then unlock the index 1, lock the index 2 and index 3, and unlock middle 1. Once you've done that, you can go into Replace and flood that influence over. And you'll see that now part of the fingers are following the index 1, but the rest is not. The very top of these fingers is now staying still because it is now influenced by the middle joint. We'll repeat the exact same process with the index 2 and middle 2. And then with the index 3 and middle 3. And there you have it. Now your index finger is correctly bound. What you have to do next is repeat the exact same process with the ring finger and the pinky finger. Except this time, your influences are on the middle finger. So you'll want to have that unlocked, and then the ring one unlocked, flood it over to the ring finger, and then repeat with the second joint, and finally also with the third joint. Now, your middle finger should be working right, and your pinky will be following your ring. Lastly, if we repeat this process with the pinky finger, you can see now that your pinky is also working the way it should be. Now, if we zero out the rotations on all of these joints and delete the keys on the index finger, now we can rotate all of them at the same time. And there you go. You have successfully maintained that smooth, even, and consistent skinning throughout all of these fingers. And they all behave the way they should, independently from each other, but also cohesively with each other. And if you take a look at the pinky, the one that I mentioned earlier, you can see that the skinning looks just fine now because it's actually being influenced by the correct joint rather than something that's all the way over here. So this is a pretty fast way to make sure that you obtain smooth and consistent skinning throughout multiple children of the same parent. And it can be used in other scenarios. It's not just fingers. Any type of case where you have one single parent and a number of children to that parent, if you use this technique, you'll be able to obtain a much smoother result with all of your children, rather than having them behave completely differently from each other.